Hi, I'm Mark Rigueur from Microsoft Finance, and I'm here with Pedram Rezai, who is the architect of one of the most exciting BI products I've seen in years, called Q&A. So Pedram, can you tell us in a few words what Q&A is?
Yeah, absolutely. So Q&A is this new product that allows you to ask questions over your own data in the most natural way. If you have some data somewhere, get it into an Excel spreadsheet, create a Power Pivot model over it, and simply upload it to an Office 365 site. From then on, you can use natural language to ask questions over that data.
That sounds very easy.
It really is.
So shall we show them how
Absolutely.
To do it?
Absolutely, let's do it.
Okay, so like with most analysts, we start with Excel. And here we have a simple pool of our cost information, thousands of rows of data on cost. So we have by function summary, by account, by group, by line item, by P&L classification, actual budget cost.
What is this VTB thing, Mark?
So VTB stands for variance to budget.
And oh, I see.
YoY, year over year. So we are creating, we created a Power Pivot out of this. And I understand, Pedram, that we can simply load this Power Pivot into an Office 365 site.
Absolutely. Let's give it a try.
So we were looking at the cost. Can I know the total cost?
Yeah, sure. So let's start with that. Total actual cost.
Wow, so this shows me the total actual cost is around $4 billion. Can I have more detail, like by P&L classification?
Yeah. So you remember the P&L classification column, right?
Yeah.
There you
and
go.
And it recognizes your typing.
Absolutely.
So you have, obviously, the bulk of our cost here shows that it's in sales and marketing, G&A, COGS, and R&D less. And can I see this information by country as well?
Yeah.
And country?
You can just simply type that. So as you can see here, what happened was we are now showing you a better visualization, which is a map. How did that happen? Well, in Power Pivot, you can mark a column as a place. And because the country column was marked as a place, we automatically discover that it's probably better to use a map over here.
Exactly. And here we see, for example, in North America, half of the cost is sales and marketing, while the bulk of the cost in China is COGS. So can I see this as a bar chart, if
I want? Yeah, so I can simply just type that in.
As a bar chart. And then we can see the total cost breaking out by P&L and by country.
Yeah, well, what's cool though, if I select bar chart, for example, I can choose a different visualization, or I can go here on the left-hand side and choose from a variety of different visualizations that the system can work over.
So it gives you suggestions. It's great. So now let's look at our performance. Let's look at variance to budget, which we call total VTB.
All right.
So it's unfavorable, minus 50 million. That's not good. I want to know more. Show me by country. And maybe by P&L classification as well. And I like to see this as a column chart. So here, this is very interesting because we see that most of the unfavorable variance is in the US, primarily in sales and marketing in green and red G&A, while we have positive variance in China, especially as it relates to our COGS. So I want to know more, for example, I want to see the variance to budget by line item, which is a very detailed view. So can I go total VTB, maybe by line items?
Sure. So let's go here by line item.
This is interesting. So I can see that business investments is positive variance. If I scroll down, travel is my worst. So I probably want to drill into that. So can I see more detail of the VTB for travel?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe, so minus 22 million, maybe by country. And maybe I want to see it as column. Okay, so here, again, I can see that for this country, we have unfavorable variance in the U.S. At minus 14 million, and that it's positive for China, so every country. Now, can I see by function summary to have an idea of organization?
Yeah.
So you just replace, you can do both, country and function summary. And we can see that most of the unfavorable variance in travel is in sales and marketing in the U.S. in a matter of seconds. So here we have seen the detail of cost, but you can actually have several Power Pivot behind the scene at the same time, right, Pedro?
Absolutely. So here we actually have four Power Pivot models, all Excel spreadsheets loaded to this Q&A site.
So when you type your question, it knows which Power Pivot to go based on the column names.
Yes, so effectively what we do behind the scene, we talk to all these four models and then we try to understand your question. Every model comes back with a score as to how well they understood the question, mm-hmm. and we usually choose the highest scoring one, and we use that to display the results back to you.
Perfect. So why don't we look at revenue? So maybe I want to see the total revenue, which is another part of Pivot that is loaded. So 234 million, maybe by quarter. And maybe I want to see it as a column. So here I can see that I have a lot of revenue in Q2 of fiscal year 13, and it went down in Q1. So maybe, can I see now total revenue by quarter and also by revenue type? You know, I want to know if I have it's my non-annuity or my annuity revenue, and maybe as a line chart instead of as a column, so I can see. And all you have to do is click. This is so easy. That's so you click on the chart type, and it gives you an option.
It's very intuitive, isn't it?
Super, super intuitive. So
you can do that with any portion of your sentence. You know, if I select revenue type, for example, oh, I can choose other things here, or quarter, I can choose other things here too.
So it gives you option. So here, when we look at revenue, typically we want to look at it by customer name. So can I see total revenue by customer?
Yeah. So by customer, maybe remove.
Remove the rest and just see by customer name. So I see one enterprise is my top customers. So maybe I want to see the total revenue for that customer, the detail.
All right.
So one enterprises, there you go. It gives you suggestions by product. There we go. So here we can see right away the detail of the product for customers. So here, I had a cost per pivot, I had a revenue, and I typed questions, and he knew where to go.
Absolutely.
Maybe we can have some fun now.
With some other model. Yeah, but before that, though, you see this little blue bar here, this mm-hmm. little blue sentence here? Mm-hmm. This is telling you exactly what the system understood.
I see.
By you typing that question in.
Okay, so every time you type, it gives you a suggestion.
Right.
And it not only gives you a suggestion about the question overall, but each individual feel, so to speak, in the question.
Exactly.
So if it's a line, you can pick a column, it's right. That smart.
Or if you're filtering, you know, you get to see in this restatement section that you're filtering the customer name.
Now, I think it's great. Enterprise. I think it's great that you have a lot of suggestion giving the number of fields you have. So can we have some fun and maybe go after public data? I understand you have some Olympic Games data up to Beijing.
Yeah, absolutely. So we have the Summer Olympic data set over here. It's only Summer Olympics, and it only includes the medalists, people who won medals in here.
Okay.
But, you know, we can ask some really interesting questions over from this data set too. For example...
So I'm a soccer fan.
Yeah.
So... Can I know who won the gold in soccer in 2008?
Yeah, let's try that. So who won gold in soccer in 2008? How about that?
Okay.
So there are two teams. Do you know why?
Well, there's usually only one winner.
Yeah, so I think it's something to do with the gender of the team.
I see. So what you're saying is that obviously Argentina won in the male and United States won in the female.
I assume so.
Okay. So can we know more about how many Americans medals we've won across the years?
Yeah. So how many American medals? So that's that many medals across the years.
So maybe we have an idea of the time series by year?
Yeah, let's do that. So we are seeing this over year. So let me just make this smaller so it's visible. Okay. So it's over the year.
Maybe by gender as well?
Oh, that's interesting. Look at this. Men, women, and the mix. And the mix here means, you know, the events that were mixed events.
So women's have increased quite a bit in the last few years, closer to the men, around 50. That's right.
That's really interesting.
So they have caught up to the men. And can we see, for example, our friends in Canada?
Yeah. So let's add Canadians to the mix as well. So this is the total sum.
So we aggregated both U.S. and Canada, so you can add that very easily.
Right.
So can we see the total, just focus maybe on the Beijing Olympics?
Yeah.
And look at the total medal standings in Beijing?
Maybe go medal standings
in Beijing?
Beijing.
So here you have a good idea of the distribution, so he knows the maps is the right way to approach it.
Right, absolutely. And you see, so we talked in medal standings, but he interpreted it as medal count.
Mm-hmm.
right, which is interesting.
And can we see this as a column chart?
Sure.
And so you see right away that channel, and you can sort it through the graph, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So you can
so
see,
and you can see, look at this,
US and China very easily.
Right.
So that's not the only way, right? You can have some preset questions.
Yep. Let's take a look at this. So here we have this little right-hand sidebar, in which, you know, when you create your own model, you can specify some information about that particular model, some really good questions that people can ask about that particular model. So here are some example questions people can ask about this particular model. So I can just simply click on those and get that data immediately on the screen.
So I see, I remember 1992. So what, you have gold medal winners in men basketball?
Yeah, let's take a look at that.
Also, you have actually the names
of
all the players.
Yeah, so, or if some of you remember, these folks were called the Dream Team.
So how did he recognize that the Dream Team was the 92?
So you can specify synonyms
for
common terms. Something like Dream Team is specified as medalists that played basketball in 1992.
So you have the ability in the tool to do synonyms. Like, for example, if people think of revenue as sales, you can write in the tool that when they type sales, they mean revenue, so therefore return revenue.
Absolutely. Or if you have a table called movies and you want them to be able to refer to it as films, you can define a synonym that says film is a synonym for movie.
That's super useful, given how many ways people call the same things. All right, so is there one last...
There's just one last thing I want to show you, just to the power of the system. So who from Vietnam won what, when? So look at this, the athlete names, what they won, and the year in which they won these.
So here it shows that two athletes won two medals for Vietnam across the years.
Absolutely. You got to remember, we don't have the data for 2012 in this particular data set. But yes.
So this is interesting because this is not the natural way of asking a question, yet it recognizes.
Absolutely.
Okay. So Pedro, I've been going to business review for years, and my biggest fear was not to be able to answer a question. So I had a lot of binders, pivot tables, power pivots. I don't need all of that anymore.
No, really, Mark. So from now, just grab your laptop, make sure you have Q&A running with some data behind the scene. From now, if an exec asks you a question, type that in, and you got the answer. You're good to go.
That's amazing. Thank you for your time, Pedro.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching.